Hi, I'm Amber from UVM Extension, and we're gonna cut a tank today. So we're gonna install float. I have a tank behind me here that's all set up and ready, so you can see how it's gonna look at the end. The first thing you wanna do is get your float out of the box. This is a Job float, and it has a ball attachment. This has like a mini arm. I use these for small tanks. This is for sheep and goats. So for a cow, you would use the size up Job float with a string attached. So it has the ball that's a little bit bigger. So the most important thing is when you decide where you're gonna put your float to make sure that you have it as low as you can get in the tank, but you still have space underneath for the water to come out. So can you see there that there is some space underneath? So I'm gonna drill this has a label on it right here, it has numbers and stuff, so you can make sure you center it on your tank. And I'm gonna put it in right here. I'm using a hole saw, and I already measured this to make sure that you can see that the hole is gonna be slightly bigger than the threads that go in, but not a huge amount bigger because it has to seal, right? All right, so go ahead and drill your hole. And you're gonna have, the plastic is gonna be there. All right, so you have your hole. Clean it off a little bit. And then you have your float. You have the screw-on part that goes on the back. There's a little rubber gasket, and I leave that part on the inside right there of the tank. So put it in from the inside, and then turn it around. And I like the flat part against the tank, and the open part is gonna stick out into the world. So screw that on. Make sure your tank is up and down so the water is coming out. Tighten it on there as tight as you can get it. And you can see that this is removable because you can take it apart and make sure it's cleaned. So just make sure that it's on there correctly and that it's tightened up. All right, so now on the back part here, you have this iron pipe thread. And I'm gonna put my adapter on because this is iron pipe thread, and we're gonna put it onto a hose, which is hose thread. 3/4 inch, 3/4 inch, but iron pipe thread, hose thread. And then here's your adapter. There's like two different choices for this kind of stuff. They have swivels like this. They have plastic ones and metal ones that swivel. They're easier to get on, but even the metal ones I find always end up leaking.
Or the plastic ones?
The plastic ones always end up leaking, sorry. And then this is the metal ones that I prefer. They're solid, these brass ones. And these are kind of annoying because not only do you have problems sometimes getting them on, but it's a little tricky to get the hose on. But once they're on, they're amazing. I like to put some Teflon tape around to kind of help with the seal. Don't use pipe dope on this because you can plug up your float. And then make sure that the tape is away from the hole so it doesn't get in there and plug the inside. So iron pipe thread. And it's on there nice and tight. And then here's our hose. And you can see that I am gonna actually just cut it off and make a hose. Because you know, when you're making stock tanks, you're gonna have like a bunch of short hoses. It's cheaper to buy a long one and cut it into pieces than it is to buy a bunch of pieces, right? So there's a couple of tricks for putting in these hose menders. So I like the metal ones. They have hose clamps that come with them. Or you can just buy this part and, you know, have your own hose clamp, whatever. But one trick is when you're putting the male parts in, they're a lot easier to get in because they're solid. The female, so here you have your female end that's attached to a male part, and we're gonna put this in. You have your hose clamp on first, and you can put a little bit of water and a little bit of soap inside here to make it a little bit easier to get it in there. So it's really tight. It's not gonna be easy to make these hoses, but once they're made, they're great because they don't leak. If you put them on and it's loosey-goosey, you'll regret it because it'll end up leaking. So even though it's annoying at the first, it's worth it in the long run. All right, so that's on. So you're gonna just tighten this up. And now you have your hose. Take that male part out right here. I actually already put the male part on the other end, so Then the one thing you're gonna do is that I do sometimes use Teflon tape on the hose to try to like make sure that it doesn't leak on the tank. Same thing, try to keep the tape out of the inside here. And this is what I'm talking about when you put these onto the tank. You have to like, you know, deal with this whole solid thing. It's not a swivel, so. But once it's on there, it's on. So that's nice and tight. And I use a port system, so on my water line. So I actually use these plumb valves. So I put the male part at the end of my hose. And then, you know, you're gonna hike your tank around the field, and this is gonna be inserted in your water line. That's like water line right there. So it has the insert for the water line. And then this just goes in here, and you can see that it clips over the edge, and then it turns it on, and that's off. And then the last part is just to put our ball on here. And then I'll show you a tank that's working and check for leaks behind me. So, and I do like these floats because they're, you know, they're not complicated to put together. And then you can, of course, adjust your ball in any direction. So when this is up, it's off. So if you look over here, here we have our tank that has water, so you can hear it's running. And then when the ball comes up, it turns off. All good. So, and you can see that there's no leaks back here. We checked to make sure there's no leaks. This is all Teflon tapes back here. And it's not running over. There's no problems. So here we are. We're done. Thank you.